Welcome back to stage 5 of this advanced demo series where we're going to clear up all of the resources that we've created. Now make sure you've got the text instructions open for this lesson because they're going to make things much easier. So first, there's a URL in the text instructions for the Cloud Resource Manager. So this takes you to the Resource Manager for Google. Once you're there, go ahead and select the Pet IDF project and then click on Delete. You'll need to copy down the ID for the project and paste it into this box to confirm. And once you've done that, click on Shutdown. Now, this does delete this project after a number of days. In my case, it's going to be deleted in 1 month's time, but you won't be receiving any charges for this. It's essentially deleted. So go ahead and click on OK. Next, move to the AWS console, and then you'll need to go back to Cognito. Then you'll need to go to Federated Identities. Once you're at Federated Identities, go into the Pet IDF ID pool. Once you're inside there, click on Edit Identity Pool, then scroll down to the bottom, Expand Delete Identity Pool, and then click Delete Identity Pool, and you'll need to confirm that process. Once that's done, go ahead and move across to the IAM console. If you haven't got it open still, then you can search for it in the bar at the top and move to that console. Then go to Roles, and then you're looking for the Cognito underscore pet IDF ID pool roles. So you should have 2, auth underscore role and unauth underscore role. So select both of those, scroll up to the top, and then delete those roles. You'll of course need to confirm that deletion, so go ahead and do that, and then delete the roles. Once those roles have been deleted, you can click on Services, click on CloudFormation, and once you're at the CloudFormation console, you can select the WebIDF stack, click on Delete, and then click on Delete Stack. And that will complete the process of removing all of the infrastructure that you've used as part of this advanced demo series. So that's everything that you needed to do in this advanced demo series. You've successfully implemented the architecture that's on screen now. So I hope it's been enjoyable. All of the techniques you've used and all of the products are equally as applicable with large, complex ID federation projects. And so what you've learned in this advanced demo series will be massively valuable to real-world AWS usage, and if you have any questions in any of the exams on identity federation. So at this point, I hope you've enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Go ahead and complete this video, and I hope you'll join me in another advanced demo series.